In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We are on our ninth day of Novena in preparation for the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception, the second Sunday of Advent. We prepare ourselves by acknowledging our sinfulness, humbly begging the Lord for forgiveness, for compassion. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Have mercy on us.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Baruch. Jerusalem, take off your robe of mourning and misery. Put on the splendor of glory from God forever, wrapped in the cloak of justice from God. Bear on your head the mitre that displays the glory of the Eternal One. For God will show all the earth your splendor. You will be named by God forever the Peace of Justice, the glory of God's worship. Up, Jerusalem, stand upon the heights, look to the east, and see your children gathered from the east and the west at the word of the Holy One, rejoicing that they are remembered by God. Led away on foot by their enemies, they left you. But God will bring them back to you, borne aloft in glory as on royal thrones. For God has commanded that every lofty mountain be made low, and that the age-old depths and gorges be filled to level ground, that Israel may advance secure in the glory of God. The forests and every fragrant tree have overshadowed Israel at God's command, for God is leading Israel in joy by the light of his glory, with his mercy and justice for company. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with rejoicing.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad indeed.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert. Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing, carrying their sheaves.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. The Lord has done great things for us.
Reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I pray always with joy in my every prayer for all of you, because of your partnership for the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one began a good work in you will continue to complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. God is my witness how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may increase ever more and more in knowledge and every kind of perception to discern what is of value, so that you may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight his paths. All flesh shall see the salvation of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, and Herod was tetrarch of Galilee, and his brother Philip tetrarch of the region of Iturea and Trachonitis, and Lysanias was tetrarch of Abilene, during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, the son of Zechariah, in the desert. John went through the whole region of the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as it is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah. A voice of one crying out in the desert, "Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be made low. The winding roads shall be made straight, and the rough ways made smooth. And all flesh shall see the salvation of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning to you all, brothers and sisters. Magandang umaga. Pakibati nga ng good morning ang ating mga kasama ngayong umbagat. Sabihin nga po natin, happy fiesta. Alam ko po, second Sunday of Advent po ngayon. Bukas po talaga yung ating celebration. But in another time, December 8 is our solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. So hindi naman siguro masama because this is also our 9th day of our preparation for the fiesta or solemnity of Immaculada Conception, eh, ipagdiwang na rin natin ang kanyang fiesta. Mons, okay lang ba yun? So, happy fiesta po sa atin. Ako po si Father Jason Laguerta, parish priest po ako ng Santa Maria Goretti Parish sa may UN Avenue, Paco. Napansin naman po ninyo na ang inimbitahan ni Monsignor Rolly at ni Father Biel na magmisa ng mga nobenaryo ay mga silver jubilarians. So yung mga nagdaang pari na nagdiwang o naging presider ng ating novena masses, many of them, if not all of them, have been my classmates. We were ordained here in the cathedral by Jaime Cardinal Sin, September 8, 1999. Dito po kami sa mismong harap ng altar nagbigay ng aming matamis na oo sa Panginoon, sa aming obispo, Cardinal Sin at that time, to consecrate or entrust our lives to the service of the Church. So kaya po ako nandito ngayon because I was invited by Monsignor Rolly and the Cathedral to celebrate this Novena Mass with you. Siguro kasi po kami ay dapat magpasalamat at dapat magbalik tanaw sa Mother Church kung saan kami isinilang na maging pari. This is the place that we were ordained, and this is where we are going back to say thank you. First of all, to say thank you to the Lord for the gift of priesthood, to Mama Mary for accompanying us in our priestly journey, and to all of you, the people of God, for continuing to pray for all your priests. At masarap pong magbalik dito at magmisa kasi This is our home, our mother church. Ako po'y taga Bicol, and every now and then, every year, I go back to Bicol, to Sorsogon, to visit my parents in the cemetery, basically, dahil doon sila inilibing. 52 years old na po ako, nag-birthday po ako noong December 5. Pwede po kayong humabol. At ako po ay never, at least in my memory, have I experienced a smooth ride going to Bicol. Sa inyo po na mga dumadaan ng South Road, going Visayas, Mindanao, by way of Bicol, Quezon Province, and all that. Sa inyo po, you can validate this. Umuwi na po ba kayo ng probinsya sa South na wala kayong nadaan ng road repair? Wala. Never. Taas ang kamay ng mga Bicolano po rito. Ayan. So alam nyo yung tatlo lang kayo. Lagi hong may repair. Lagi hong malalaki ang butas ng daanan kasing laki ng crater ng buwan. Lalo pa pag dumating ka na dyan sa may bandang Tagkawayan, papunta ka na ng Adlaya Highway, o sa mga Bicolano rito, alam nyo yung sinasabi ko, talagang tatagtagin ka, sisirain ang sasakyan mo, gasgas ang iyong gulong, at pag-uwi mo ng Manila, repair. Endless repairs. Both the roads and the vehicle. And I think this is what John the Baptist was telling the people when he was preaching to them. Repair your lives. And not just your lives, but repair and prepare the way of the Lord so that He can come to us smoothly. Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight His paths. Every valley shall be filled. Every mountain and hill shall be made low. The winding roads made straight. The rough ways, the rough roads made smooth. So that we can see the salvation of God. Advent is the time for us to make some major repairs in our lives. There are many aspects of our lives that need to be sorted out. There is primarily the tendency to be arrogant or selfish, to lower down our pride, to know the meaning of humility. There is also the invitation for us to look into our own weaknesses and shortcomings so that God can fill us up. We have also made so many wrong decisions that led us to detours in our lives. The best way to prepare for Christmas is what John the Baptist is telling us today. Make a major repair of your lives. So we ask ourselves, what is in need of ordering or sorting out in my life today? Ano yung mga bagay na dapat isaayos, isalansan, itama sa buhay ko ngayon? I was talking to a parishioner recently, and she was telling me, "Father, I don't know how to sort out our family. I don't know where to start because my family right now is really in disarray, complete chaos in the home." Nagsimula po ito, Father, yung problema namin sa pamilya nung ma-discover ko po na meron siyang iba. At nakita ko po, nalaman ko ang kalokohan ng asawa ko dahil po sa screenshot. Hindi ho original yung screenshot sa showbiz. Sa totoo lang po, sa mga buhay mag-asawa, yan madalas ang pinagmumulan ng kaguluhan sa pamilya. Pakitingnan nga ang katabi mo, may screenshot ka na. Diyan nagmumula ang maraming away, kaguluhan. At lalong lumala dahil yung asawa niya, nakita niya na ang ebidensya, ayaw pa rin umamin. At lumala ng gusto dahil naisama pa yung mga bata, nagkampihan ang mga bata. Si daddy kakampi ang bunso, si mommy ang kakampi ang matanda. Sa bahay namin, Father, ang description niya, para kaming Korea, North and South. So she asked me, where do I start restoring peace in my home? Where do I start and where to begin in sorting out our life? Ang sagot ko sa kanya, to sort out and to restore order in your home, you must begin with your heart. That's the first step. At ito yung hinihingi ni Juan Bautista sa mga nakikinig sa kanya at hinihingi rin niya sa ating lahat sa panahon ngayon. If we want to reorder and to make a great reset in our lives, we must begin with the human heart, with our heart. So we ask ourselves today, what is in need of restoration and sorting out in my heart today? If my heart is so broken that it's not able to forgive, maybe that is where the Lord wants you to start. Diyan ka magsimula. Kung ano yung nagbibigay sa iyo ng pinakamalalim na sama ng loob. Kung ano yung pinagbibigay sa iyo ng pinaka nakapanggigigil na pagkamuhi at galit. That's where you are supposed to start. And mind you, it is not easy. Madali po ang road repair papuntang Bicol. Kung wala lang hungkurap, panigurado, malinis ang daan papuntang Bicol. Pero mas mahirap, isaayos ang puso at kalooban. Madaling i-repair ang daan. Madaling i-renovate ang katedral kung may budget din lang naman. Pero yung puso, yung pamilya, yung buhay, nangangailangan ng pagbabalik loob, nangangailangan ng kababaang loob. So on the second Sunday of Advent, as we prepare for Christmas, we go back to the most important decision that we will make today and every day. How to face my broken heart? How to address my pained and frustrated self? How to begin healing by way of looking at myself in need of conversion, of repentance, of change? And we ask Mama Mary, the blameless and sinless one, the immaculate one, we ask her, Mama Mary, help me in my desire to repair my broken life. Mama Mary, the immaculately conceived, help me to eliminate all the stains caused by my mistakes in my past. Help me to live a clean and purer kind of life, so that like you, I may always be ready to give birth to Jesus in my life. Mary did not need any sorting out because she was immaculately conceived. And therefore, Jesus was born through her smoothly, swiftly, no hindrance of obstacle along the way. She was so pure, so immaculate. That's why when Jesus was conceived in her womb, and when she delivered Jesus in the manger, yes, around them there was chaos. But in the heart, in the womb of Mary, there was only peace and joy because she was ready. Her heart, since the beginning, was immaculate. And that is why her womb, at the same time, was ready to bear the Savior of the world. In this Mass, as we prepare for Christmas as well, like Mary, let us cleanse our hearts of everything that hinders the Lord from coming to us, from being born unto us this Christmas time. Repair, repent, sort out. This is the invitation of the second Sunday of Advent.
Please stand.
We profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
John the Baptist proclaimed that all mankind will see the salvation of God. Therefore, we pray confidently for the needs of all God's children. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Catholic Church may be pure and blameless in all her members, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who direct our lives by laws and regulations may always seek the good of all men, women, and children, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people without faith may discover that the Lord has done great things to us and be filled with joy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our hopes for the world peace may be fulfilled as the Lord leads us to Christmas, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the eternal light of salvation may shine upon those who have died, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and merciful God, for you all things are possible. Fulfill our hopes and intentions as we confidently pray to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. stand.
Pray, dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer, exultant in his praise. And so with the angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer You, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that You have held us worthy to be in Your presence and minister to You. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, Your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in Your mercy. Welcome them into the light of Your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all of the saints who have pleased You throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify You through Your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through Him, and with Him, and in Him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is Yours forever and ever. We are all children of the loving Father, and He calls us to be with Him. We pray together as His family. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant peace in our days. By the help of Your mercy, we may be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not, Lord, on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace to you. Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Very sorry we ran out of consecrated host. We will just do spiritual communion. You will follow the prayer over the TV monitor. We are very sorry.
Michael said. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for some announcement.
Again, I am very sorry for some of you being deprived of receiving the consecrated host during Holy Communion. We really did not expect this much, but I gave instruction earlier to prepare for more. Eh, siguro dahil si Father Jason ang nabalita ang magmimisa, kaya dinumog kami ngayon. So thank you, Father Jason, for bringing these people to the Manila Cathedral. Father Jason was my former student in high school seminary, and I'm very proud of this batch doing it well. And as he mentioned earlier, this year they are celebrating their silver jubilee. Please continue praying for them that they may reach 50, healthy and still a priest. And as I said, token of our appreciation earlier, I've been looking for an image, so we are giving you the replica of the Immaculate Conception enshrined at this sanctuary. And also thank you for coming over to the Manila Cathedral. And well, few announcements. Today is obligatory because it is a Sunday. Tomorrow, it is not obligatory as decreed by the bishops of the Philippines because it falls on an ordinary day. But you are very much encouraged to go to Mass also tomorrow because tomorrow will be the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. Having said so, our schedule for the schedule of Masses tomorrow would be at 7:30 in the morning, 12:10 in the afternoon, and then there is an additional Mass at 6 in the evening. So pwede po kayong mamili kung saan nyo gustong magsimba o anong oras ninyo gusto magsimba. Pero mamaya po, pagkatapos ng Misa ng alas 6, ay magkakaroon po tayo ng prosesyon ng tatlong images ng Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal, the Immaculate Conception, and Our Lady of Lourdes, because today we are celebrating the 170th anniversary of the declaration of the dogma of the Immaculate Conception. So as a celebration, these three images that are closely linked with the Immaculate Conception are being processed tonight. So if you are free, though you have already gone to Mass today, you may also return here this evening. Hopefully, we will be blessed with fine weather. Medyo umaambun-ambun na sa labas, no? Hopefully, we'll have a finer weather this evening. So, tomorrow is the fiesta. Tomorrow, we have extra Mass at 6 p.m. It is not obligatory tomorrow to go to Mass, but you are highly encouraged to go to Mass even then. And after the fiesta, we're going to prepare for Christmas. And the Simbang Gabi will begin on Sunday, December 15 at 8 p.m. And on the following day, December 16, the Dawn Mass will begin at 4:30 in the morning. So December 15 to December 23 will be at 8 p.m. And December 16 to December 24 will be at 4:30 a.m. Still, we have regular Masses at 7:30 and 12:10 from Monday to Friday, and 7:30 in the morning on Saturdays, and 8, 10, and 6 p.m. on Sundays. Hopefully, we will not run out of consecrated hosts then. So, sorry po talaga. So, and again, I would like to thank you for coming over. Let us thank also our liturgical ministers. Palakpakan po natin ang nagsilbi. Thank you.
Please stand.
I'm very, very sure 99%, 100% you did not come for me. I think you came because you thought today is the feast day or the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. Indeed it is, but tomorrow is our solemnity of the feast, but your obligation is fulfilled today. Monsignor Rolly, Father Biel, thank you for inviting me. Thank you for allowing me to celebrate Mass here in the cathedral where I was ordained 25 years ago, September 8th, the birthday also of Mama Mary. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our loving God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.